Oh, God. Floodlit fish is the next level. But I have a big rant to go on. I can't go on a big rant while I'm playing this fucking level. This Sorry, I just want to I'm trying to like my throat wants to stretch and I can't quite get it to. Okay, hang on. How do I headphone cord? How do I get you to unkink? How do I do that? There has to be a way. There must be. By the logic that, you know, sometimes you are kinked and sometimes you are not, there must be a way for me to unkink you. So, hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Donkey Kong Country Returns. Or, no. That's not right. Dixie's Double Trouble. Dixie's Double Trouble. It's like the most, like, kitty, like, Dixie's Double Trouble. I have nothing wrong with the title. It's just that this is, it's one of my, I don't know, synesthesia or some shit. It's like I used to hate when I would say, "Oh, I have to go to class," because the "ah" sound in the word "class" just sounds so nasally and juvenile. And it's the same way with like Dixie's Double Trouble. It's like there's not a single syllable, there's not a single phoneme in that entire title that doesn't sound like Dixie Double Trouble. You know. Anyway. This level is kind of a pain in the ass. It's really simple. Like, basically, it's literally just, jeez, man. Hey, that was easy. It's really simple, actually, and I think there's only two secrets in this level, and if this one was that easy to find, then I have a vague idea of where the other one is, so hopefully we can find it, but, oh my god. I don't know what is wrong with my computer. It has been really struggling lately, like hitching. That last episode of Tears of the Kingdom I recorded was really bad, like with that. It was like every, like multiple times a minute, the audio would just like, you know, it just sounds so stupid. You know, it's like I do what I can to. Like I might set up whatever shortcuts I possibly can to make my recording job easier, to take work off of my back, you know, to relieve myself of work in as many cases as possible. That's weird. There's like a, it's cool. Like the sound that those things make. I never noticed that those things make a sound before. When you turn the light on, it goes like, wah. And what's cool is that it actually harmonizes with the music. Yeah, like, listen to that. Because there's that repeating motif, that it's always the same notes, just an octave up or down, and that sound effect totally harmonizes with it. That is so cool. Of course, that repeating motif isn't always playing, but it's still cool. Anyway. Man. Okay, it is August 3rd, okay? And I have work tonight, and I do not want to go! Fuck! You know, I was all excited for this week, because it's the first week that I'm having in, like, a month and a half, I think. Like, at least a month. I've had, like, basically work every single, weeknight. Like, starting from 6 and going to 10, which is, I know, it's piss hours. I know I keep saying that. It's like, I feel like I have to keep emphasizing it in case people think I'm trying to, like, You know, it's like Tim said in that old LP, in some old LP, he's like, people will find any excuse they can to prove that their life sucks. And ever since hearing that, I've kind of found myself going out of my way to avoid coming across that way. Whenever I want to complain or vent about something, I always feel like I have to qualify it with, oh, well, I know, oh, but yeah, but I know that, you know, I don't have it that bad, you know, other people have it so much worse, you know, blah, 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 blah. And it's like, dude, like, it's okay. You can be fucking, you can have a hard time with things, just, you know, it's such an easy, predictable, and obnoxious, like, ethical trap to fall into, the idea that, like, you actually can kill those things. It looks like they might. It looks like they would be opening and closing too quickly for you to do that, but they're actually not. Why is this? Oh, you know what I just realized? I have the sound in BizHawk turned down to 64%. Why is it so quiet? Hang on a second. What the hell? OBS, what are you doing? Since when is that? Oh, God, no! No! Since when does it do that? It didn't used to do that. Ah, fuck! You can't... Oh, no way! Since when does OBS pay attention to the system volume? Stop hitching like that! God, that's so annoying! Okay, that's enough, alright? Wait a second, I wonder if I can, like, set a property with that. Hang on. Okay, apparently it's... Oh my god. Oh my god. Apparently it's a problem with the audio drivers. I guess I have to reset my computer again, because I did reset my computer recently, and I think that's when it started happening. How annoying. Okay, so... Why can't anything just keep working? Stop it! Stop breaking! That must be that. Okay, so it's not just the capture card. I guess that's good, because yesterday, the other day, I was recording Tears of the Kingdom, and I was worried that my capture card was fucking up. But I guess not. I guess it's just a problem with my fucking audio drivers, because not a single person in the universe can leave well enough alone. Like, I'm telling you, if we could get everybody in the world to adopt the, you know, to adopt the idea of leaving well enough alone, the world would be such a better... Well, I don't know if it would be a better place, but it would certainly be less... It would certainly be more consistent, you know? Like, stop changing things when they don't need to be fucking changed, please! So I guess once this video is over, I'll just... go figure out how to fix that. I guess in the meantime, I can turn up the volume in OBS. Why can't I? Oh, because I unfocused the window. Stop! 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 Ha! Pothole panic. Okay, this is exactly what I did. This is exactly, I hate that word, exactly. It's like, you can't put that many fucking, how, it's like, you can't put that many consonants in a row, man. Exactly. It's like, ugh. Okay, anyway, so this is Animal Antics, basically. This is DKC3's answer to Animal Antics, Pothole Panic, and it's really annoying. It's pretty fun, but, it would be fun if I was in a fun mood right now, and if this... You know, the game hadn't... If my computer hadn't decided to throw one of its witty-witty hissy fits. Ooh-woo. Can I sneak under you? Watch me swoosh right out. Okay, so basically... So my job, okay? Okay, so... fuck you. I don't want to go in. I've been working like 5 day weeks, right? And I was all excited because what the hell? I was all excited because I've been working five weeknights a week, and I was all excited because I got 2 days off this week, so I was only working Monday, Tuesday, and now today's Thursday, and I'm working tonight, and that's it. However, last Thursday was absolutely god-awful, okay? And it was bad enough that, like, it got the attention of management, because the people who were there, the customers, were unhappy enough- FUCKING COPTERS! They were unhappy enough with the service they got to, like, actually, like, bother the owner of the place for refunds. Now, like, wanting, like, some of them, so, like, I think there were, like, six people who tried to, who contacted the manager and was like, we want a refund. Oh my god. I see, every time it happens, I see my capture card on the left, I see the light blink off. So, oh my god, what the hell did you mess up, Windows? What did you break now? Name that game. Stop! 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 Please! So anyway, these shit-ass customers, they were such, it's this new group okay? Like, when I started working there, everybody that came in, all the customers that came in were people who had been there before, right? They were groups that had been to this golf course before in previous years. They had a developed rapport with the staff. They knew what to expect from us. This new group started coming here, like, maybe a week ago, or not a week ago, like a month ago, maybe. And they are entitled, pouty, petty, and completely unreasonable. Like, I don't know... I don't know how these motherfuckers... Like, okay. The people who come in from the golf course, sometimes they're like, oh, we all want to sit down and eat together. And it's like... That's... Like, I understand, okay? We have one cook in the kitchen. 30 people cannot order food and expect to be fed at the same time. I don't care how good your Dan Dory is in the kitchen. It is impossible to simultaneously... I don't care how many burgers you can fit on the grill, how many French fries or chicken fingers you can fit in the fryer. You can only dress... One person is only capable of dressing one bun or assembling one sandwich, assembling one dish at a time, okay? So when 20 people come in all at once and order 20 things in 20 minutes, even if it only takes me 2 minutes of active time to prepare each item, that is already more time than I can literally physically, like, that's already, I already literally physically cannot keep up with that. But do they care? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Okay. But do they care? Of course not. No, they don't care. Somewhere around here, I should be able to obtain Dragonite. Do you think Dragonite is really made from dragons? Anyway, I'm attractive, don't you think? Okay. By the way, I'll give you a fresh egg. I'm pretty sure there's a fucking... I'm pretty sure there's a spider somewhere around here. Or Squitter. He has a name. But anyway. So these fucking shitheads come in, like, all at once, order 20 things in 20 minutes, and I'm scrambling, trying to assemble, you know, because three of them ordered fucking wraps, like, right at the beginning. Three of them ordered chicken Caesar wraps right at the beginning of the night. And that is, like, extra ridiculous. Because that alone set me back like 15 minutes. Because our tortillas are so beautifully, you know, selling pointily soft that you literally cannot fucking... Oh my god, are you serious? Get on the fucking elephant, you dumb shit! What are you doing? Oh, you have to be holding the jump button to land back on the elephant. Well, that's dumb. Okay, anyway. Yeah, so it's like... You know, three people order chicken Caesar wraps. Crispy, which means that the fryer is taken up because I need to, you know, cook the crispy chicken tenders in the fryer. And then I need to assemble all three of these chicken Caesar wraps, which is not fast because, oh, you know what? In DKC2, Squitter couldn't jump on enemies, but he actually can in this game. Shit. No, that's fine. Okay. We just need to... Oh my god. Oh my god, holy crap, my computer is freaking out. I am so... Ah! There is literally like a half a second delay on everything I do all of a sudden, and I'm just wanna try on an array of clothes. Okay, so the last secret up here is up here. Actually, I think this might be the DK coin. No, it's a Boshi. It's a Boshi. So, yeah, and like by the end of the night, the last couple orders, because they all came in simultaneously, were like 40 minutes late, and that's obviously unacceptable, but you know what else? But like, what the fuck did you expect? You know? Like, literally, what the fuck did you expect? You all waited until everybody, because listen, motherfuckers, I know how golf works. You didn't all finish playing the last hole at the same time, okay? Even if you started Like, even if you started on different holes so that you all, you know, could play your 18 holes or 9 holes concurrently, you know, in like a canon, in a beautiful canon, I know that you didn't... Where's the hell's the DK? Did I already get the DK coin? Ow. There I go. I see my capture card over there freaking out again. Yeah, here we go. Here it is. Ow. But anyway, they were all pissed off, and one guy came in, and he was like, I'm leaving right now, I'm leaving right now, where's my food, I'm leaving right now, and like, two people who were working the pro shop were like, where's his food, he's leaving right now, so I'm like, okay, here's your fucking food, and I put it in a to-go box, and he fucking sulks and pouts, and he's like, I didn't order it to go. I'm like, if you are gonna light a fire under my ass saying that you are leaving right now, and you need your food right now, you're getting your fucking food in a to-go box. But anyway, so after all that nonsense, my boss actually, like, when I got there on Monday, my boss, like, took me to the shed, and she was like, she's, like, understanding, she knows that this is fucking ridiculous, but she was like, how can I make this easier? How can I make it easier for you to keep up? And I'm like, I got a fucking idea. Why don't you book me and the new person that you just hired, you know, to deal with these fucking harpies, you know? Why don't you book two people on the hardest nights? And she's like, I can't afford that, can't afford that. And I'm like, so, let me get this straight. You're hiring more people not to make the work easier, but to give people a break from the exact same but to at least be able to allow a break from the exact same bullshit, which is, you know, it's like, it makes sense. I mean, if you can't afford to, you know, Jesus Christ, computer! Ah! If you can't afford to book two people, like two people's worth of shifts in the week, then that's just it. You can't afford to work, book two people's worth of pay, you know, two people's worth of shifts in the week. But it's like, so she agreed that she would actually stick around, because normally she leaves like by six, like when I show up. But she agreed, like, okay, like. She suggested, like, maybe I could make an easy, like a really easy special and, like, try and push it more. Something really fast. And I'm like, okay, that's not a bad idea, but it's not gonna work because people are gonna order what they wanna order. You know, you can put as many exclamation marks on the little whiteboard that says what today's special is. It doesn't mean that people are gonna order it. You know? I mean, how many people ordered the special that day? Like, not a lot of them. Not a whole lot of them ordered the special that day, that awful, awful Thursday. So, you know, that's not really a solution. So she said, okay, I'll stick around at the end of my shift, and I'll help you with the rush, I'll do the cooking, and you can assemble and, you know, whatever. And I'm like, okay, alright. So that should, on the one hand, that's good, because, oh, right here, the DK one is down here. It's like I'm not even talking about the game. I'm just like, just all of a sudden, I'm just like, oh, by the way, the DK coin's down here. So you know, hopefully that means tonight the rush won't be quite so cat. Because I've cooked for these guys before. It's not my first time cooking for them. Not that I expect them to have developed any sort of, you know, understanding for me personally as a person. Because, like, clearly they don't understand that, like, clearly they don't understand how understaffed we are if they think we can, you know, prep and serve 20 orders simultaneously. Oh, God. One shot at this, huh? Oh, is this the one with the... Oh, God, it is! Oh, no, it's not. Okay, this is this one. In the Lost World, there's one of these green banana ones where, basically, you have... You're way down on the ground, right? And there's like a buzz. There's a buzz like in the right in the middle, right near the top. And you have Perry, that like bird that flies a certain distance above your head, right? And all the bananas appear up at the top around that bee, and you have to make the bird like, jump around and over the bee while avoiding hitting it. It is so nerve-wracking because he doesn't quite follow you, like, perfectly. Like, he lags behind you a little bit, so you need to, like, account for that, and it's really tricky. Do I want to fight Barbos right now? Yeah, I do. But anyway, so yeah, she's gonna be here. She's gonna be there tonight, which is, like, good. It'll probably, you know, having two sets of hands will probably make a significant difference in our ability to, you know, handle the rush. The problem is, having her in the kitchen psychs me right the fuck out. Like, when she's not there, my confidence level to be able to, like, prepare any item on the menu reasonably fast, emphasis on reasonably, is, like, you know, maybe, like, 95%. Oh, for God's sake, you stupid fuck. Yeah, my confidence level in terms of, like, being able to prepare any item on that menu is usually, like, around a 95 to 100%, right? When she's in the room, my confidence level is, like, 30 to 35. Because she is extremely particular. God damn it! She is extremely particular. You stupid motherfucker. She is extremely particular about, like, the way things are prepared, to the point where we have now had at least one argument about the way we cook our burgers, because she cooks them halfway, flips them, and then, for some reason, crushes the shit out of them after flipping them. I'm like, dude, you're squeezing out all the juice. But she claims that it makes them cook faster. I'm like, I don't know how it could possibly cook faster when you're squeezing all this, you know, all this juice out of the burger and cooling the grill down. Like, that doesn't make any sense at all. But okay, whatever. I guess you're the boss, boss. Well, whereas I slap the burger down, right? And then basically, I smash the burger down. I slap the burger down on the grill. I smash it into the grill with the spatula. I need to be holding the, because I think, fucking, it is taking all my willpower to not be dropping C-bombs. I've gotten way too used to saying that, to using that word, like, offline when I'm ranting to myself about my job. But yeah, like, yeah, I do, like, the thing where you smash the patty down into the grill and then cook it, like, 80% of the way on one side. Because that way you get, like, a really good crust on one side of like, browned flavor. But that's not the way that she understands how to make it, and she has pulled the "I've been working for 15 years" before, so I'm like, okay. Oh, she told me, like, okay, I can cook a burger in just under 7 minutes. You know, all I want, basically, like, she dismissed the argument at some point as saying, you know, like, I don't care, fucking bitch, as long as you can cook a burger in 7 minutes. So she was like, okay, time it. And I did, and I cooked a burger with my method in 7 minutes and 30 seconds. And I wrote it on the board. And she didn't even come in yesterday. Or I guess two days ago, on Tuesday. Because we had, like, a freak storm that morning. So nobody went out on the golf course, so clearly she didn't bother working the kitchen, because there would have been nobody eating. So obviously when I got there, the moment I got there, like, 3 people ordered and nothing was on. So everybody got their food like 10 minutes late because I had to wait for the fucking grill to heat up. Yep. Got him. Actually, I believe Barbos is a female. Got her. So, you know, whatever. But apparently, she actually was there, because she left a note, and all she said was, "Good job timing yourself. Keep trying." And I'm like, bitch! I am 30 seconds off! If anybody, if anybody complains because they got their burger in 7 minutes and 30 seconds instead of 7 minutes flat, I don't care about appeasing them. And I guess that's my problem. I guess I shouldn't be working a line cook if I don't care. But, I mean, there comes a point where it becomes overkill, okay? And we passed that point 15 minutes ago. We passed that point 16 minutes ago. Anyway. There's my... Well, gee, after the last episode where we barely talked about my job at all, we have this episode where I'm like, I ran out of game to play, ran out of episode before I ran out of rant. So, that's gonna do it for me. Next time on DKC3, we begin Chaos Core. This is the final world, kind of. You know, this is like K. Rool's Keep, basically. But don't worry, there's still a lost world. A lost world that I haven't really played recently. So that'll be fun. Bye! And wish me luck.